Do you want to introduce yourselves, your kids' ages, how many kids you got, and how you found becoming a new parent?
I'm Ali. I've got a daughter who's 5 and a son that's nearly 2. I've been a single parent from the day I found out I was pregnant with my daughter, and to be fair, I was looking forward to it until she was born and found it very stressful.
Can
relate. Yeah, definitely. Definitely. I've got 2. One is 3, one is 8 months. When I first became a parent, it was quite stressful, but it just came naturally, basically.
Connor, I've got 1 kid, she's 1 year old. Becoming a parent, obviously suffering mental health and stuff, it was a big struggle to start off with. But I think eventually you just latch onto it and just go with the flow. Cool. So when you become a parent, did it change like relationships with, if you had a partner or your friends or your family, did it sort of like strain any relationships or just change it in any sort of way?
Me and my now partner at the time, when he was first born, we kind of went through a rough patch because it was stress on both of us. But we managed to work above that and move along.
That was the same with me. Like me and my partner, first 6 months were brilliant. Like, we went back to honeymoon phase, so like start a relationship.
Yeah.
You know, both like, oh, you've got a baby, that's sort of, you know, this is our family. And it just sort of strained towards the 6-7 month point because we were so sleep deprived and aggravated with each other. So when your baby's crying, you know, ferociously, and you're like, please stop, how do you cope with it? Like, how would you cope with it?
Off the top of the head, basically, like at the time, you just kind of wing it because you don't really know what to do at the time, apart from obviously try and deal with your child at the precise moment. But afterwards, like, you know, if you've got a partner at the time, you can essentially ask them to help. Obviously, with you being on your own, it's a lot harder.
That's what I wanted to touch on, like being a single parent. How would you deal with it? Like,
well, when she was first born, like my brother used to have her for a few hours once a week, just so that I could get some, well, not get my own time as such, it's more of having a couple of hours without any screaming sort of thing. But the way I dealt with it was just, I ignored it, but just carried on through sort of thing, where now they're a little bit older, I've got another one to add to the mix. It's like I take 10 second breather in the bathroom sort of thing, like just to calm down, get myself back down again.
I don't really find it that hard to deal with it, but obviously other people in different scenarios, depending on, you know, what's going on in their life or
situation,
any sort of factor can change it. So I think it's different for everyone. So I don't think there's an overall coping mechanism. I think it's just how you would cope yourself in a stressful situation.
So every parent has their own way of dealing with a situation, whether that's like just screaming in your head or just like screaming into a pillow at a time. Like,
I mean, we've all been there.
Yeah,
we've all
been just like walking you feel into like, your garden, yeah, and you just feel like screaming you're on breaking.
You feel like you're on breaking point, but you know you've got to be there for your child, so you can't lose it.
Because obviously it's not the child's fault, because the child is completely it's completely oblivious. Like, you know, they're still trying to do what they do as a do baby things.
So yeah, exactly.
They're still kind of developing and learning.
Yeah, they've got to learn, you know.
They're embracing and taking on the world.
Routines, which you're trying to get them into, they've got to learn.
Their emotions.
Exactly, they don't understand it, and they've got no way of communicating towards you, whether they're hungry or they've got an itchy, you know, they have an itch on their nose and they're getting frustrated because of that and they can't itch it because they haven't learned.
I think it also depends on what age they are sort of thing. If it's a baby, then they're going to be screaming, they're going to be crying because they can't communicate.
So, have you had any experiences of getting angry and having to sort of remove yourself from a situation? And if so, do you mind sharing them at all?
Numerous amount of times.
Yeah, I've got a couple.
So it's like when she won't go to sleep, and I've been screaming, shouting, whinging, whining, and this has been going on for about 3 hours. I've walked out into the front garden sort of thing, screamed. I've obviously phoned someone to obviously just offload to bring myself back down again.
Yeah,
and then obviously come back in and try and tackle it again sort of thing, or like remove myself from the situation. But it is quite hard, to the point that there's been a fair few times that it's literally just reduced me to tears, because it's like, well, can I actually do this?
Yeah, so like, am I doing this correctly? Am I going to break?
Getting frustrated. Yeah, something could happen prior to that. Myself. You could have an argument with your other half, a friend, a family member, and that can bring up a lot of anger in yourself. And then you lash out in stress and are a bit frustrated and not take out on your child, but they get a bit more of a hard time because you're having such a bad day.
Yeah.
Do you have any advice or techniques to help someone deal with their, I know we touched on this earlier, but to deal with their crying baby. Obviously, like we said earlier, everyone's got a different coping mechanism. But it's
definitely
not,
offload.
Yeah.
Offloading. Like and, offloading yeah. helps
being
a hell
able
of
to,
a lot.
Like me and my mate Lee, we literally have about half hour conversations on the phone at some points when both of our partners have got the kids. We're on the phone like, bro, I'm going to go mad.
Well, no, yeah. Unfortunate enough, just to be able to go, right, give me 5 minutes, I'm just going to go for a ride on my bike and I'll just put my gear on and I'll go.
But then it's even the same as, like, obviously, if you are a single parent, when the kids are in bed, make sure you take time for yourself,
yeah.
even if it's just to, like, pamper yourself, having, like, an hour's bath
and a
sort of thing.
Yeah.
That's what I mean, just remember to take time to
all the old,
for
all
yourself,
the old ones
to
nap.
Even
like,
if you don't
asleep.
Get the time
the
break.
The nap, like,
I can agree strongly
literally,
with
the
nap.
The almighty nap, like, okay, they're down.
Nap when they nap. So we've got, take a 5 minute breather, take a nap.
Yep.
Offload.
Pampering.
Or time to yourself.
But yeah, it could be just a break. So, touching back on what we were talking about earlier with the anger and the immediate crying and stuff like that. Do you know, like, the most common reasons for a baby to cry are? We have got a few facts here. We've got them from the NHS website. So the most common ones are hunger, dirty or wet nappy, which is really common. Tiredness. Wanting a cuddle, which you just stated
yeah.
there. Wind, which is a big one, because a lot of people don't actually know how to wind their baby properly, and that causes colic and stuff like that.
Reflux.
Being too hot or cold, boredom, and overstimulation. So, there's a few pointers which are like, you can sort of follow, because we've given like the general of our experiences,
yeah.
but the one on the NHS website give quite more in depth and a more general field of how you can soothe a crying baby without losing your temper and getting angry and stuff like that. I'll just point out a few of them. So for mothers, if you are breastfeeding, the baby suck at your breast, that comforts them. Rock your baby backwards and forwards, like you were saying, with the bop and the bounce. Find something for them to listen to or look at. So it could be like stimulation videos and sensory
yeah.
videos. And
even sometimes it's just like motion noises or
anything. Undress your baby. Baby massaging is really good. Nice belly massage, chest massage. They've got pressure points all over the body you can massage, which can calm them down. Warm baths, and sometimes too much rocking and singing can keep your baby awake. They state here as well, so that could be a factor as well.
Yeah, but like mind state, such as because you're waking them up, because essentially you're
yeah.
talking to them. So they're trying to register what you're saying.
The main cause of abusive head trauma is the shake of that could be out of frustration, anger. And it's just stating never, ever shake your baby out of anger. Or aggressively, because that can cause long-term brain damage, which can affect your child's life. So I think it's really important that we do get out that
the message.
Do not shake your baby, no matter how frustrated you'll get. Find your
calm
you
down.
Time.
Yeah, find that box that you can just
yeah.
go in.
Your little bubble.
Yeah.
Sit in there for 5 minutes, come back.